Good day, ma'am. I am Jimuel Siaton from Section Kilo. I have two topics, reds counting and wall tracing. First topic is all about reds counting. What is reds counting? Reds counting is the process of counting the reds that touch or cross an imaginary line drawn between the delta and core of the loop. We have four rules in reds counting. First is locate the exact core and delta. Second, delta and core not counted. Third, there must be a white space between the ridge to the next ridge. Fourth, count all the ridges that cross or touch the imaginary line between the delta and core. I have an example of ridge counting. First rule is hanapin mo yung core at delta. Dito yung core at dito yung delta. Then, kapag nahanap mo na yung core at delta, dun ka na magsisimula magbilang. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We have 15 ridges. The third rule is there must be a white space between the ridge to the next ridge. Yun ang halimbawa ng ridge counting. And the next topic is whorl tracing. Whorl tracing, the technique of the whorl tracing depends upon the establishment of the focal points. The ridge emanating from the lower side or point of the extreme left delta is traced until the point nearest or opposite the extreme right delta. The number of ridges intervening between the tracing ridge and the right delta are then counted. We have three rules in whorl tracing. First, tracing begins from the left delta until the extreme right delta is reached. Second, is tracing begins from the left delta until extreme right delta is reached. Third is when the red trace ends abruptly and eighth ridge definitely ends the tracing, drop downs ends the tracings. The next lower ridge immediately beneath the point where the ridge above, continuing from there. We have three types of whorl tracing. First is inner, second, outer, third is meeting. What is inner? Inner, if the red trace pass inside the right delta and three or more ridges intervene between the tracing ridge and the delta, the tracing is designated as inner. I have an example of inner. Remember, in the whorl tracing, we have a two delta, the left and the right. Dapat hanapin mo muna yung dalawang delta. But in the left side, dapat dun ka magsisimula patungo sa right side. Dito yung left delta and dito naman yung right delta. Dapat makonekta mo yung delta dito sa left patungo sa right. Ganyan lang pagkonekta. This is a ridge. Konekta mo lang doon patungo sa right delta. Then kapag nakonekta na, then kapag nakatapat na sa right delta, dyan ka lang hihinto. And then, we have a three or more ridge intervene between the tracing ridge and the delta. 1, 2, 3. We have a three ridges. The second type of whorl tracing is outer. What is outer? Outer, if the right trace pass outside the right delta and three or more ridges intervene between the tracing ridge and the right delta, the tracing is designated as an outer. I have an example of outer. In the application of whorl tracing, hanapin mo yung left delta. To yung left delta, then pwede ka, kapag nahanap mo na yung left delta, pwede ka nang mag tracing. 1, kapag naputol at bababa ka. 2, at naputol naman, baba. 3, naputol, baba naman. 4, then naputol din hanggang makatapat na yung right delta. Ito yung right delta dito. 1, 2, 3. We have 3 ridges. And the last is meeting. Meeting is all other tracing are designated. I have an example of meeting. Ito yung left delta and ito yung right. Kapag nahanap mo na yung left, doon ka na magsisimula mag-trace. Naputol, bumaba patungo sa right delta. Wala tayong mabilang kasi iisa lang yung ridge niya.